Thank you. I just want to thank the gentleman from California and all my colleagues who came to the floor in the aftermath of that hour from the GOP side, basically criticizing on the Republican side the health care reform, the Affordable Care Act, also known as Obamacare. I you know, sometimes when I listen to what the Republicans say about Obamacare, I'm shocked because I don't think they understand how many people are out there who've already benefited from it and who are really looking forward to October 1st because they can sign up for the first time for health insurance. And let me tell you, in my own district, I've had so many inquiries about from people who are uninsured or underinsured or who can't afford the health insurance they have now. And I just want to say, you know, I agree with the gentleman from California that this was basically resolved last November. It couldn't have been clearer that the president, for whom Obamacare is known now, was out there in the presidential election saying that the Affordable Care Act was a great accomplishment on his part and he was going to continue with it. And then you had Mitt Romney on the other side saying that if he was elected that he was going to repeal it. And so my colleague from California is right. That was resolved in the election. So why is it that our colleagues on the Republican side are trying to hold the health care reform hostage and saying that if we don't repeal it or delay it or defund it or whatever, we've had so many votes on this, over 40 now, that they're going to shut the government down. One has nothing to do with the other. And you know, I just want to talk about those three groups of people who were most positively impacted by Obamacare beginning October 1st. First of all, we know we have about 40 million Americans who are uninsured. Many of them are from New Jersey. They don't have health insurance options right now. This is going to be the first time October 1st that they actually have a rational, legitimate option to get health insurance. And they are waiting for October 1st to come around. Secondly, we have just as many people, maybe 80 million people, who may have health insurance, but it's very skeletal, doesn't provide much in the way of benefits, and they have to pay a lot of money out of pocket if they get sick or they have to go to the hospital or whatever. Those people also will benefit because every health insurance policy that's offered under the health exchange that the gentleman from California talked about will be a good benefit package, at least as good as what we know now as, say, Blue Cross Blue Shield. And then you have the third group of people who may have health insurance, but they're spending so much of it in order to make sure that they have health insurance or spending so much money that they can't pay for their rent or they can't pay for their mortgage or they can't put food on the table. All these people are going to benefit come October 1st when they can sign up for a good package and an affordable package. And one of the main reasons it's affordable is because the federal government is helping pay the premium, helping subsidize the premium with tax credits, but not tax credits that you have to pay up front and then you get a refund when you file next April 15th, but a tax credit like a subsidy that goes directly to pay for the premium. And we're all already hearing, you know, I've said this to my colleagues in New Jersey now, they're saying that the average health insurance policy is going to be about $350 a month. That may not seem like, you know, some people say $350 a month. That is incredibly affordable for a lot of people in New Jersey who are paying a lot more right now. And that's without the subsidy. With the subsidy, that can go down to $100 a month, depending upon your income. So I can't stress enough how important this is. And for the Republicans to try to hold this hostage, no one on our side of the aisle is going to give up on the Affordable Care Act because we know people need it. And we are going to move forward, and hopefully they come to their senses and don't keep trying to shut this government down. I want to commend the gentleman again. Thank you.
Mr. Pallone, thank you so very much for your comments about New Jersey.